Let's talk about how to rewrite piecewise defined functions using the unit step functions. And here are two forms that were given in our textbook for where we have piecewise defined functions that we can rewrite using unit step functions. Let's talk about why they're rewritten the way they are. Now notice that with my first function here, it's g of t when we're less than a, h of t when we're bigger than a. So when I go to rewrite this function, I want it to start out having the value g of t, but I want to turn off the g of t as soon as we hit a. So we turn on unit step at a, if we have it the unit step of t minus a, then all of a sudden as soon as we hit an a, it becomes a 1. So to turn off the g of t, I'll subtract away the g of t times the unit step. That way it's 0 before I hit A, so this term's not here before I hit A. And then as soon as I hit A, this becomes a 1, and we're left with just g of t minus g of t, which is 0. But now I don't want it to be a 0, I want it to be an h of t. So we're going to go plus h of t times the unit step at t minus A, because again, as soon as we hit A, unit step here becomes a 1, and we're left with just h of t. So now we'll do the same thing over with this one. For this function f of t, I want it to start out being a 0, but as soon as we hit a, I want it to be a g of t. So g of t times the unit step at t minus a will turn on the g of t function as soon as we hit a. Now, as soon as I hit b, I need it to go back to a 0. So I want to turn off the g of t, so we're going to go minus g of t, unit step t minus b. Well, we have a g of t in common, so I can factor that out and write that as g of t times unit step at t minus a minus unit step at t minus b. Now see, if we're less than a, then we're certainly also less than b, so both of these are 0. 0 times g of t would be 0. As soon as we hit a, this becomes a 1, this stays a 0, so we just have g of t. And then as soon as we hit B, this is still a 1, but now so is this. So I have 1 minus 1 inside the brackets, which is a 0 times g of t is a 0. So we'll use these as a model to help us rewrite other piecewise defined functions. Let's start with f of t equals 0 when we are less than pi, and sine of t when t is bigger than or equal to pi. This is like the first function that we talked about up here. So here the g of t is a 0 and the h of t is a sine of t. So if I look at this equation and I plug in a 0, this term would be a 0, this term would be a 0. That means I don't need to bother to write them. All I have left is h of t times the unit step of t minus a. H of t in this case is sine of t, so I'd rewrite this function as sine of t times the unit step at t minus my a is a pi, right? So that's it. We're done. We've rewritten it. That's correct. Now, one thing that we're going to see is going to be to our advantage is we might notice this t minus pi here. I'm going to see later I might want this as a t minus pi. Notice that if I go all the way around the unit circle, by subtracting pi, that would take me all the way around the unit circle to the opposite side. That's going to change the value of the sine from a positive to a negative. Think about the reflection across the unit circle. So I can take it back to the exact same value by making that negative sine of t minus pi unit step t minus pi. So I could also write the answer in this fashion. We'll see that'll be useful to us later. All right, let's look at another piecewise defined function. F of t equals, and this time we'll do a three-parter, so 3 if we are less than 2, and e to the t if we are between 2 and 5, including 2 and 0 whenever t is greater than or equal to 5. All right, now we're sort of like this third part, but notice that up here we had a 0, and here I have a 3. So I want it to start out with the value 3. So we're going to write f of t is equal to 3, but I want the 3 to turn off as soon as I hit the 2. So minus 3 times the unit step at t minus 2. What do I want to turn on at 2? I want the e to the t term to turn on to 2. So plus e to the t times the unit step at t minus 2. But I want the e to the t to turn off at 5. So minus e to the t unit step t minus 5. What do I want to happen after 5? I want a 0. I'm going to get a 0 automatically, so I don't need to do anything else. So if I simplify this a little bit, we would have here 3 minus 3 times unit step t minus 2 plus e to the t times unit step t minus 2 minus the unit step t minus 5. And now we've rewritten this in terms of those unit step functions.